Hey, Gary?
Hi, how you doing?
Gary? Okay, Steve, you're on with Gary Marshall from Scotland.
Hello, Gary.
Hi, Steve, how you doing?
Good, there's a bit of a delay.
There is just a wee bit, but it's not bad.
Okay, good.
We're in Scotland at the moment, and it's snowing.
I love the snow. I know you're probably tired of it, but I love the snow.
What's the weather like in San Diego at the moment, then?
Well, you know, right now it's kind of cloudy. I looked out, I have a little thermometer. It's about 55 degrees. We're supposed to get rain on Friday and Saturday. So that's the report from Southern California.
Well, congratulations, Steve, on the success of the single, Don't Stop Believing, and, of course, the album that was released this week here in the UK. And it's selling like hotcakes.
I know. In my wildest dreams, I would have never saw in my mind's eye this thing resurge like it has. Don't Stop Believing has got legs of its own, and because of that, the greatest hits from Journey has been re-released. You know, that's the greatest hits from the period that I was in the band back in the day.
Well, that's right. We're going to come to that in a little minute, because you've been with the band, you've gone away, you've come back again. But the single Don't Stop Believing, which is in the top five at the moment in the singles charts, that was also used at the end of The Sopranos. And you were a bit worried about the way they were going to be using the song, weren't you?
Well, I did. I mean, I always sort of watch out for what's going to happen to the music. I kind of oversee I just keep an eye on it emotionally to make sure people aren't going to get whacked while the song's being played, you know? And so that was my concern. So David Chase, people got a hold of my publisher, and they assured me that this is the way the ending was going to be. I knew everything about the ending except for the go to black moment. And so I approved it literally the Thursday before it was to air on Sunday. I approved it. The Journey members had already approved it, not wanting to know what happened, but I was a little more concerned about it, I think, than they were. So I was glad to know that it was used in a good way. But when I watched the show that night, I was as surprised as everybody else when it went to black, and I loved it. I was one of the few people that when they just cut to black, I thought, now that's an ending.
Now, Steve, the band Journey have been going since, 1982, thereabouts, and apart from the fantastic music over the years, which you've obviously been heavily involved with, the album covers are a world of their own as well, aren't they?
Yeah, we worked really hard with Anton Kelly, who recently passed, and Mouse, Kelly Mouse. Kelly and Mouse were a team, mm-hmm. and they did all the album covers for the Grateful Dead and a lot of different San Francisco art music bands. So we brought them in, and they did all our covers, and they did such beautiful jobs on all of these covers.
The solo career, that's on hold at the moment, but you are going to be pursuing that again, I would imagine, once the promotion for the greatest hits from Journey is out the way. Is that right?
Well, you know, I definitely left the group in 98 after we had tried to get together and do Trial by Fire, and that worked well. But it turned out to be a trial by fire, and we went our separate ways again, not to use cliches, but yeah. We did. And then they've been touring with some other singers. And so since then, I've been sort of recouping and living my life and just sort of, you know, just hanging out with friends and writing music for some solo stuff that I will be recording soon. And that's kind of exciting, yeah.
And you've come a long way, Steve, I think it's fair to say, with Journey, etc., from the days of Alien Project. That was the band you had in your mid-20s. Any plans to revive?
You've done your homework, haven't you? My goodness. Yes. There was a group called the Alien Project, which later became the same group called Street Talk. So, this funny enough, my solo album, which was to follow years later, yeah. I named it in homage of that group called Street Talk. I named my solo album Street Talk. So, yeah, those were the days. We were a great little band, and then one of the members got killed in a car accident. And that was almost the end of my pursuing the music career. I thought, if this is what it's going to happen, you know, I get so close and something happens. And then I lost a dear friend in a car accident who used to sing so beautifully and played bass so well. And we wrote great songs. I thought, maybe I'm not supposed to be doing this. And so I went back to my mom and I moved in and I said, Mom, I think I need to come up with some other way of living. And she said, no, you need to pursue this. And you should go back. And I licked my wounds and went back to Los Angeles and tried again. And then I got a phone call from Herbie Herbert, who was managing Journey at the time, who got a phone call from Columbia, who loved the band I was in. And they simply said, well, why don't you come up and meet the band? And the first thing I did was fly to Denver, Colorado, and I met Neil Sean. And after their show, which I wasn't performing with them yet at that time, after their show, we wrote Patiently together, and that was the beginning of the whole run with me and the band. You know, I was ready to run. I was ready to just give it up because I guess I had stopped believing, not to be coining a phrase, but I just got given up, you know. And because she told me not to quit, not to stop believing, I just said, okay, I'll do it again, though I really was emotionally distraught because this bass player, Richard Michaels was his name, from Detroit, wonderful singer, wonderful bass player, and we wrote some beautiful things and sang great together. It was sad that he was taken so young, but, you know, from that came the journey opportunity, and I always do my best to try to mention his name because he was really talented, and I'm grateful for having known him, you know.
Now, Steve, you're in there in the 100 greatest singers of all time. Queen's Brian May described you. He said, in his opinion, he said, a voice in a million.
Goodness, I owe Brian May some money after saying that. I owe him cash.
Send it to me, and I'll make sure it goes to him then, right?
Please, okay, great. We'll do that.
Now, your voice, actually, it's described as a tenor altino. Is that right? It's a term used to describe a man who sings in the highest possible male register. It's above a woman if she can actually get that high. Is that right?
Well, I think I was probably one step from a castrati back in those days. I mean, I'm not quite that high anymore. But, you know, but it was definitely was high. I mean, that was just, you know, when you're young and you don't know what you're doing and you can do whatever you want to do, you do it.
Yeah.
You know? And so I didn't know what I was doing, but I just went ahead and did it, you know.
Now, over the years, you've worked with some big stars, John Bon Jovi, you've worked with Clan Ad and Scotland's very own Sheena Easton from Bells Hill.
Yeah, well, Clan Ad was definitely my favorite. I mean, I was hanging out in a studio in West Los Angeles, and Greg Ladani was working with Clan Ad, and my goodness, you know, he was just doing this beautiful record, and I said, God, I'd love to sing some stuff, so we built this whole vocal sort of backward thing I was singing in the midst of that. It was a real great experience meeting those people because I was truly into that landscape of beauty when it comes to music, and it was a new thing hitting at that time. You know, you had Clan Ad, you had Inya, and I was truly captivated by the landscape aspect of it, how it was a broad visual thing musically. And so I was really excited to work with those guys, and that was a fun time.
Excellent. All right. Well, look, congratulations on the success of the single Don't Stop Believing. As you say, it seems to have legs of its own, doing really well in the UK chart. And well done on the album, Journey Greatest Hits. Something I noticed when I looked up on Google, Steve, was you bear an uncanny resemblance to two very well-known showbiz superstars here in the UK.
Who's that?
Alan Titchmarsh and Ali Bally.
Well, I've never heard of whatever a Titchmarsh is, but Ali Bally, now that I know of.
Have you got any plans to come to Scotland?
You know, I'd love to come over there. Are you kidding me? I would love it. That would be a thrill of my life to perform there. Gosh, I mean, seriously. So perhaps in the future that's going to happen.
Well, you know you're welcome here. And Steve Perry, thanks for coming on, and all the very best. Cheers, mate.
Thank you so much.
Just a small town girl living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going in.